And then we additionally also seen whatever the titles they are mentioning over here, that can be given as something like this. If it is a colon, we are not using any brackets, it's just the double quotes in a combination of or. Add or architecture. So whoever would have written engineering manager or head or architecture in the text field of the over here, only those results are coming. This is not the location part. This is only the keywords, additional keywords, what candidate would mention. And here we have a number of contributions. We can click on each and every contribution or commit, and we can see when and what. And we also understood the difference between projects and the repositories. Yeah, pretty much about it. Any further questions, any doubts, confusion on this part?
Shiv, one more question. Over the previous pointers you have mentioned, 2015, 12, 30, that one I do have one doubt.
Yeah, tell me.
So it's regarding particularly the candidate recently joined, right? 2015, that I understood, but you also mentioned 12 and 30 last.
Yeah, when we're giving a white string. I lost you. Hello?
Hi, Shiv. Can you hear my voice?
Yes, Sushmita, we can hear you now.
So one thing is that I have a doubt in the strings, which you have mentioned creator 2015 and aroma 12 and 30. In the strings.
Before or after? Either before
yeah,
or
yeah, this one.
Yeah.
So 2015 is a year and 12
is a month. It's a year month date format. You can see here. If you go to advanced now.
Yes.
Okay. Created dates. So you have a format here. Year hyphen month hyphen date.
Okay.
Popin, you were mentioning something within the two different ranges, right? Let's say after 2015-Jan-31st. Let me just come here once. Let's say in case this cheat sheet has an option of giving the in-between ranges. Okay, jQuery size dot dot of the file. Yes, number insert here. Created, updated. Created since the beginning of 2013, last updated before 2013. Mm-hmm. So can we give the ranges in between these two? After December.
So we'll get the profiles in between 15 to 18, right?
I'm not really sure. Earlier it used to work, but now it's not. So let me remove this again. Created after 2015. Jan 31st, created colon before 2018, December 31st. This should give, wow.
Okay.
Yes, this will give. So let's make a little greater string. Language Ruby, language, let's keep only language Java. Super. So someone who has created something after 2015 and created something before 2018. So someone who has created something before 2018, will it exclude someone who has created something after 2018? There might be people who has created after 2015 and before 2018, but also those are the people who might have created something even after 2018, 2019, 2020. So how does it helps me? But it will have a minimum use case of someone who has created before something before 2018 and after 2015. So that means I would still get a profiles of people who have created something after 2015. Though I'll get a people who have created something after 2015 also, but I'll sort it by most recently joined to avoid that. So in that case, I would still get the combination of someone created after 2015, someone created something, also someone created something before 2018. Let's see how this the option works. And then do our basic maths if that is working. Confusing or are we aligned?
Yeah, it's aligned.
This person. So definitely we have someone 2015 and 2018. So as I mentioned, someone might come who would have created something after 2015 or before 2015 and 2018. Okay. So before 2015 and 2018. Okay. Still to before 2015 or 2018. Okay. Before 2018. Okay. 2018, before 2018, he has created something, but not after 20. Okay, so it's meeting a use case of the candidates, someone who has created after and someone who has created before. It's not meeting both the use cases. It's giving me the combination of either after, because this profile is not from someone who has created something after 2015. If I have to take this. So now how to sort that? So this is giving me the result definitely of people who has created something after 2015 and also definitely people who have created before 2018. If I look at this resume, this profile, he would have created something on that particular 2018 date, what the date we have mentioned over here, 2018, December 31st. That's the reason we are getting this particular profile. So yeah, September he has created. So we have given someone who has created something before 2018 December. So in September, the person has created in 2018. Yeah, yeah. Okay, so now we'll go and we'll do most recently joined. So meeting those two scenarios so that we have someone who has joined at least on or before 2018, because we have given something before 2018. Let's do this now. Let's come back to fourth page later. So most recently joined 2021. So created, this is contribution, created something. See more. 2021, joined GitHub only in 2021. How this profile is coming? Created something after. After also we gave. So 2021 is still after 2015. So it's meeting any one use case. It's again unlikely the way we have given language Java or language PHP. Okay, the way it is taking Java or PHP. Similarly, here also it's taking someone who has created after 2015 after 2015 or someone who has created before 2018. So when I say after 2015, and when I say most recently joined, I'm also getting a profile of person who has joined GitHub in 2021. The reason, because that falls under the use case of someone who has created after 2021. So it's not meeting the use case of only profile who has created something only after 15 and only after before 18. So it's not meeting that. It's still taking a OR option. So to modify this, is there option? Can anyone please suggest any further options? Created. This did we try?
GitHub doesn't understand range operator. Range operator, it doesn't understand or.
No.
Not taking.
Are we trying to find out who has created and who's recently also working on it?
No, we are trying to find out if it is meeting both the use cases. I want only the profile who has created something after 2015 and before 2018. I don't think it is possible. So this is still giving me the option, created. Okay, let me not use on or before. Okay. Here in this example, we have not used on or before. Created after 2015 something and created 2018-12, exact date. Okay, created nahi hai to post. This is created. Post. Repository is post. Let's say remove this created and use it in post. After 2015-01.
I think it should be month and date at the last.
No. This is only giving it from this particular user. This is definitely giving us a list of profile who would have pushed a repositories after 2015. Post before 2018-month. I don't think so. When I say most recently joined, I should not get this 2021. I should get somewhere before 2018. No, not existing that use case. All right. As Bobin, you were asking whether that particular created between 2 dates can we give? No, there's not a opportunity. Earlier it used to work. I do remember that dot dot used to work. But I don't know, for some reason it has gone now. As I mentioned, like every 6 months there will be a changes in the entire social media, some or the other minor changes, but that would definitely impact in a bigger way to us being the sourcers. That's really nice. Like, you have to keep be on top of it. Yeah, tell me please.
Are you also will you also use for iris.com to sourcing purpose?
Hirist.
Yeah.
Hirist. That's of IIM job, right?
Not particularly. We can source all kind of profiles. What I have heard, I'm not yet used.
Hirist. Basically, Hirist is a job board. You can do the job posting. What we are doing here is sourcing.
That's a job post. Yeah, yeah. We can't source profile from Hirist. That's a job posting. Okay. Like in IIM jobs is for a management.
Do I have an option of sending message or something here?
Actually, Hirist is taken over by Naukri. It is part of IIM jobs.
Yeah. No, mm-hmm. IIM jobs and actually IIM jobs and Hirist. IIM jobs
is Hirist.
IIM jobs.
And you can buy their database.
That's again is a premium subscription. Otherwise, free, one can do the job posting on Hirist.
Yeah, you can talk to them and buy it.
All right, that's it for today. Madhusudan, we do not have an option of sending a message, but yes, how we can identify their email IDs based on the URL patterns and based on other things, we'll cover tomorrow. So, identifying the email IDs of the candidate and then how to reach out to them. And then additionally, how to use this extensions like OctoHR or OctoHunt, what you see here over here, that we can cover in tomorrow's session. But otherwise today, I just wanted to cover briefly only on a search algorithm part of a GitHub, which is really, really important. All right, so that's it for today. Any further questions?
The number of results what we are getting, is it going to be same even though I log in today and create a profile?
It will be same unless they are increasing. Let's say tomorrow 100 new members come, then tomorrow you would see that additional 100 numbers.
No. Okay. No, but today if I log in and give the same search, I will get this 10,610 result.
Okay. Across, other team members also, can you please the same search and see if you're getting the same numbers? Let me just ping you in the chat. Location Canada. Language Java, language PHP, post after 2015-0131, post before 2018-1230. Just see if you're getting the same numbers or does it differ on account to account. I don't think it would differ from account to account. It would be the same.
Same thing, I just...
Yeah, Satish?
The number is the same. I just tried. I have put the same search. I've got the exact number.
Yeah, it would be the same. So yeah, that's it for GitHub direct searches. So we have further more things to learn, more interesting ones. Maybe by tomorrow we'll cover.
Thanks, Shiv.
Thank you. Thanks, everyone.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Bye. Yeah.